Good morning, everybody. May I remind you this morning of the Word of God, the promises of God in Jeremiah 29, verse 11, where God says, "For I know the thoughts that I think towards you, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you a future and a hope." And then in Psalm 118, verse 17, we read, "I shall not die, but live and declare the works of the Lord." The New Living Translation says, "I will not die. Instead, I will live to tell what the Lord has done." I know that these times are still challenging, and there's a lot of fear that we see. There's a lot of things that are happening in people's lives today, even at church. I know everybody can't be at church on Sundays. Some have been exposed to the virus, some other challenges that people have. But I want to encourage you, let us not lose hope. Let us continue to serve God. Let us continue to be faithful and remind ourselves of God's promises over our lives, that He has plans, He has thoughts over our lives of a future, and that we shall not die. We shall live, and yet we shall tell of what the Lord has done in our lives in this time. Amen? And as we worship and as we praise God, let us give Him the glory this morning, saying, "Lord, amidst our circumstances, amidst this pandemic, amidst the challenges we are facing, You are still in control. You are still Lord of Lords. You still have those thoughts over our lives, and we will tell of Your goodness." Amen. Let us worship and praise God together this morning.
come on, come on, come on. Where are my worshipers? Jehovah.
Woke me up this morning, starting me on my way.
This morning that we can declare your faithfulness and your goodness over our lives. Thank you that you are in control of every situation. Thank you, Lord, that you are with us, that your plans, your thoughts for our lives are coming into fulfillment in this time. Thank you that you have called us to build. You have called us to be wise builders. You have given us everything we need to be able to do this. And thank you, Lord, that everything we need in the blood of Jesus, through the works of what Jesus has done, we have everything we need to conquer today, to conquer every challenge that we are facing. And as we hear the word of God, thank you this morning that you work in our hearts, that you revive our spirits, that you work in our circumstances. And Father, thank you that we can rest assured in your love and your goodness in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. We are excited about God's word always. And today we are going to recap a little bit on what we did last week and the previous weeks. So Matthew 25 verse 21 says, the Lord said to him, "Well done, good and faithful servant. You were faithful over a few things, and I will make you ruler over many." He didn't say, remember, "Well done, good and talented or gifted or whatever servant, you know, educated servant." He said, "Well done, good and faithful servant." And therefore, you and I need to learn to be faithful in the little things. When we are faithful in the little things, God will appoint us over the greater things. But so many people want the greater things. They want the promotion now. They want the crowds clapping for them. They want the achievements within their lives. But they haven't learned to be faithful with the little. Now, you cannot conquer tomorrow unless you have learned to conquer today, to be faithful in everything that God has given you today. Faithful means that we master the process, doing that which we need to do every day, in our quiet time, in our devotion, in loving our spouse, in loving our children, and being faithful in imparting in the people's lives around us. And therefore, we need to enjoy the process. Rather live for today and enjoy today than just wishing for tomorrow and you have a miserable life. But then he continues in Matthew 6 verse 25. He says, "Do not worry about your life, what you will eat or what you will drink, nor about your body, what you will put on. Is not life more than food and the body more than clothing?" So for those who get upset and easily moved when you are rejected, and when you are rejected and it affects you in such a degree, It means then that you are living for the acceptance of others. That means you do not have character. That means you do not have faith in God. That means you do not know who you are in Christ. And therefore, the word of God comes in and says, surely life is more than money. Life is more than image. Life is more than being accepted by others. And therefore, we've got to understand, we've got to master the process. We've got to love today. We've got to conquer today. And then we see, how do we conquer? We do that by being faithful today. Understanding that God has called us to be mothers and fathers of nations, to impact and to build in other people's lives. Because here is the thing, if you are lazy yesterday, you're going to be lazy today and tomorrow. But you know what? When we are faithful and we master today, what will happen eventually, we will get that promotion there where we are going. And therefore, you and I need to get to a place where we learn to be faithful where there's no audience. Only the audience of one, and that is God. Learn to be faithful where there's nobody clapping for you, nobody even maybe encouraging you. Learn to be faithful in your marriage. Learn to be faithful in the family cell. Learn to be faithful in your tithing. Learn to be faithful in those things, in forgiving, where nobody sees you, nobody claps for you, but learn to be faithful, and so you conquer. Now, today's message, we're looking at Matthew 4, verse 18. And we see Jesus walking by the Sea of Galilee. He saw the two brothers, Simon and called Peter and Andrew his brother, casting a net into the sea, for they were fishermen. So in other words, they were working for a living. And in verse 19, Jesus said to them, follow me and I will make you. In other words, follow me and everything that I am, I will invest in you, your life. Follow me and I will make you. And when we look at this, we look at Jesus and we see he didn't have an attitude of what can I get out of you, or what can I get from this situation. It wasn't about himself, rather it was about them, and for their sake that he said, come and follow me. Let me tell you, when we follow Jesus, it's not for his sake, it is for our sake, for our good that we do it. And he calls his disciples, he says, follow me, and I will empower you. I'm going to develop you. I'm going to change you. I'm going to resolve, you're going to be resolved from being a fisher of fish, in other words, Abram, to be a fisher of men, becoming an Abraham. And in your life, if the word doesn't empower you, if you are not being developed, if you are not being changed, as a Christian, I leave a question mark there, because this is what the Word of God does. This is what the blood of Jesus does. This is what the Holy Spirit does. This is what it does when we have communion with other fellow Christians. We are being challenged. We are being changed continually within our lives. And now he comes and he says, I will empower you. And I will empower you in such a way that you will get to a place where you will start empowering other people. In other words, I will increase your capacity. And this is important. Our capacity must increase in the Word of God. It doesn't help you live on 1 minute messages for the rest of your life. You need to grow to the 2, to the 3, to the 4, to the 10 and 20 minutes where you can absorb it all and walk in faithfulness in the will of God for your life. So they say in verse 20, immediately they let their nets, they left their nets and they followed him. So you've got to understand that God chose working men, not people that were not working. And therefore, you see, today we find many people that are unemployed, but they are still working. See, some people are unemployed, but they sit at home, they sleep late, they get up, they go socializing, drink coffee with their friends, gossip. Then you're not working, then you're not doing anything. You can't expect God to provide for you. But some people are unemployed and they are working. They get up early in the morning. They make sure their family is ready. They make sure everything is in readiness. They go out, and sometimes they will even work at places where they don't get an income. You know, so see, it's not about money, slave, because we're not slaves. But it is about knowing who is your provider, that God is your provider. And God will open the right doors for you and he will provide. So you can be unemployed and you can be a worker. You can be unemployed and you can be faithful. Or you can even be employed and not working. Employed and you're sitting the whole day, you're playing your solitaire thinking, well, at least your boss doesn't see you, the whole day taking lunch hour for more than you should, not working the way that you should be working. And maybe your boss don't see you, and maybe nobody sees you. But at the end of the day, the person that deems you faithful, the person that really promotes you and take you into that new level, that person who really sees you and who really knows you, he is the one that knows exactly what you are doing, and he knows exactly when and where he can promote you or not. So this is the crux of it all. You and I need to get to a place where we put in everything, where we give our best. It is a resolve, it is a spirit. So these type of people are the people that God employs, that God comes through for. And therefore Jesus chose working people. We see the same in verse 21 with James and John. They were busy in the boats of their father Zebedee, and they were mending boats. So the previous guys were fishing, but here they were mending boats. So he said, right from now on, I'm moving you to from fishers of fish to become fishers of men. From providing just for yourself by empowering other people. From self-preservation to nation building. From working just to earn a living, I am empowering you to working to make a difference, to impart, to empower, and to build other people's life. And therefore, we need to get a change of attitude within our lives to bring this into realization, this plan that God has for us. And the illustration that I was given is, if you go to a restaurant and there's a waitress helping you, for instance, and she mess up the order, it is cold, the food, and she brings a different orders. Now what do? You come and say, hey, this is bad service. I want to speak with the manager. This is not allowed. This lady doesn't know what she's doing. It doesn't work this way. And look at this mess, you know? And when you react like that, it means you're still an Abram, you're still a Sarai. But when your identity is changed and you become an Abraham and a Sarah, and you realize you are a mother and father of nations, things change. Let me give you a change of this whole scenario. What will you do if that same waitress is your daughter? Will you still call the manager? Will you still do what you do? Or will you, as a mother, as a father, come and say, my girl, let me sit with you for a while quickly. You know you got our orders wrong. You're messing up everything. Where's your focus? First of all, you need to focus. Second of all, if you can't remember the order, get a pen and a notebook and start writing it down. Third of all, be up and about. Know what's going on in the kitchen when the food is still hot. Bring it out to the customers. Otherwise, you're not going to get a tip for the day. And you know what? At the end of the meal, you still tip her. Why? Because she is your daughter. Because you are a mother of nations. You're a father of nations. See, we need to see ourselves like that. Then it will not just be about self-preservation. It will not just be about, oh, they need to serve us, or what can we get out of that situation. It will be about, what can I bring to the table? What can I teach? What can I impart? And how can I empower these people within my life? Because this is a change of thinking that each and every one of us needs to go through. And therefore, I want to read in 1 Corinthians 13 verse 11, when Paul comes and he says, when I was a child, I spoke as a child, I understood as a child, I thought as a child, but when I became a man, I put away childish things. What did I do? I put away childish things. So you are perhaps 50 years old and you're still childish. So thinking, you know, well, I deserve better service. Still thinking, well, you guys don't know who I am, because it is all still about you. You are still Abram. You haven't become Abraham yet. You're still Sarai. You haven't become Sarah, the mother and father of nations. And when Paul speaks about, I spoke as a child, I understood as a child, I thought as a child. The word thought in Greek means to occupy oneself with reckonings and calculations. So it has to do with your reasoning, with your point of departure, with the way that you process. So you still process as a child. You still think as a child. And therefore, you still act as a child. And you still speak as a child. For instance, people that have been married for 15 years, but you are still reason like a child. You're still living in the same system as before you were married. You don't realize the two has become one now. So now you are still operating in the child system. You are married, but your wife must not disrupt your life. She must not disrupt your dreams, you know. That's why you speak about my finances and my business and my economy, my things in your life. And even when people have children, you know, you have children, but you don't want to go into this new system. You're still in the old childish system that mustn't disrupt my life. That mustn't disrupt my dreams, you know. I'm going to do what I need to do. And you know what? You need to grow up, mom and dad, because you have children that are depending on you. And you have children that you have set an example to. See, an infant is someone that cares only for themselves. They care only for what they want right now. They don't care how many people's lives they disrupt. They don't care what they destroy in order to get what they want. They just want this thing, and they will disrupt people's lives. They will destroy things to get what they want, because I want it now. I want it now. And I'm talking about adults here. I don't care who I destroy. I will put anything on the line to get what I want, and I want it now. I will go lock myself in the bathroom, you know. That is why you still have an immature marriage. That is why you still have an immature family, because you are still in the childish system. That's why Ephesians 4:23 comes and it says, be renewed in the spirit of your mind, renewed in the attitude of your mind. So put away this stuff. Ephesians 4:25, therefore putting away lying. You're 50 years old and you're lying. Why? To impress who? He says, let each one of you speak truth with his neighbor, for we are members of one another. Verse 26, be angry and do not sin. So the Bible says, do not let the wrath goes down on the sun goes down on your wrath. So you can go to the bathroom until sunset, but then you've got to get out, you've got to sort it out. There are many more, but time is up. Let me just say this. Let all bitterness, wrath, anger, clamor, and evil speaking be put away from you with all malice. So see, you still gossip. No, you don't take offense. You come and you build in their lives, you correct people, you disciple them. You and I cannot afford to be struggling with issues of sin and issues of attitude in our lives. You and I, we are mothers of nations, we're fathers of nations. We need to take responsibility. But here is the thing, many times we think we're not good enough. We think God cannot do this through us. We think less of ourselves. And we don't see the power that God has placed within our lives. We don't understand the power that God has placed within us to conquer every situation. You come and you say, Pastor, I hear you, but I can't do this stuff. This is not in me. I do not have the capacity. See, you're down talking yourself again. You do have the capacity. If you look at a seed, every seed, the potential of that seed is a tree. Everything that a tree needs to have is already in that seed. And today I'm here to tell you that I see a tree in you. But it is important. You cannot grow unless you are planted. You need to be planted. Planted in the Word of God. Planted in a church. Planted with leadership and say, I'm planting myself here. I want you to teach me. Planted in the Holy Spirit. Planted in God's will for your life. So you can receive water, that you can grow, and that you can be consolidated to everything that God has called you to be. But I am going to stop here today, and we are going to pray together. This is a mouthful. Maybe there are still childish systems within your life, and you've never realized it up to now. And I want to encourage you to deal with it, to get, I always want to say with a program, get into God's Word. So Lord, I'm putting this stuff away. Lord, there we are. I don't believe in myself. I'm coming to you. And this is a process. This happens overnight. This is a process where you start to grow and to change, becoming the mother, the father of nations in who God created you to be. I trust that you are blessed by today's Word, and that you will learn to conquer the small things within your life. Just where you are, let us pray together. Say with me, Heavenly Father, I know that you have called me, that life is more than food, life is more than survival, life is more than making ends meet, life is more than image, life is more than impressing others. And I thank you, Lord, for your life that you have placed on the inside of me. That there is a calling on my life to be a mother and a father of nations. And today I make that decision to put away childish things, childish systems, and step over and change my attitude and change my resolve to that as a mother and father of nations. Lord, you have called me to be a world changer and a history maker. That is who I am, and I accept that. And even though I am still in seed form, thank you, Lord, I see the potential that you have placed within me. Within me is nations, and within me a legacy will be birthed. Nations will be touched, generations will be touched and affected as I start taking responsibility in fathering and mothering those around me. I am a world changer. I am a history maker. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. God bless.